La da 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 da.
Hey, what's up, my peeps? It's Wednesday. It's time to talk about real worship. Tonight, obviously, we were not meeting. We will be doing things virtually. I've got a special presentation for you. It's our Three Bros You Know Christmas edition. I've been posting those things on our Three Bros You Know YouTube channel. Love for you guys to subscribe to that channel so you can watch that video. But we three youth pastors got together and had a conversation about Christmas. Love for you guys to connect with that if you've not watched it. And then also be able to listen to just our hearts as we talk about Christmas and as we sing about Christmas. So Christmas, I'm not done with it yet. I'm going to hold on to it. I hope you guys will as well. Big things coming up. We are going to be out of pocket most likely for a couple of weeks. We are not going to start small groups until later, maybe mid-January, just with the COVID numbers, the way that we as the church whole, we will not be meeting in small groups again until closer to the 17th on a Sunday, possibly the 20th for Wednesday. More to come on that. So you need to kind of stay tuned, be subscribed to this YouTube channel, make sure that you're getting announcements. But as we are journeying through this virtual time, kind of going backwards a little bit with the pandemic, I got something special for you. So starting next Wednesday, we will have a virtual service, if you will, where I'll have some music put together. I'm looking forward to possibly having something special for us to have recorded for next Wednesday. I'll have a sermon. I'll do a kind of a 15-20 minute time to talk about just whatever God's placed in my heart. But we will also have game time. And that game time is going to start that night, but it will not end and we will not celebrate the victory until we're back together again physically. Hopefully this will last that long. We are going to do a virtual bingo game. So how's that going to work? I'm going to prepare a bingo card. Bam, bam. Got different activities on there. And as you go through your day, as you are connecting with one another, as you are doing things on campus, off campus, doing your daily walk with Christ, you'll be able to mark some of those boxes off. And then I'm going to give you prizes. Like, so it's not so much you're competing with everyone else, even though there will be an element of that. You'll be competing against the card. So if you are able to get bingo across, if you're getting a full cover bingo, those will all represent the types of prizes that you'll be able to acquire when you arrive back here physically, hopefully in January. So look forward to that. That will be fun. So there'll be some things like doing a Bible study with your friends. So you're going to have to give proof of that. So if you have a card and you kind of mark it off in your mind that you did it, that's not going to be enough for me. I'm going to need a selfie. I'm going to need a video clip. I'm going to need a text from your parents, maybe someone else of authority in your life that you can validate that you got this stuff done. There'll be several tasks where you'll meet me, possibly. I'll have a predefined moment in time where you can come and hang out with me. Maybe that's at Starbucks. Maybe it's at IHOP. Maybe we're watching a movie together, that type of thing. And I'll have all this kind of pre-planned out on the card. And you'll know that if you want to come and check that box, then you'll have to come and engage. Now, it won't be a formal youth event, but it'll be something where I'm there. I'll check your name off and that box will be cleared off for you. I'll be evidence enough for you to mark that off. And so we'll just have some fun with that. So if you can only do a row, then you get a certain level of prize. If you do the full cover, then you get a certain level of prize. What we'll do is we'll not really do a drawing as much. Maybe with the full cover, we may do a drawing. But if you go through a row or a column and you're able to get bingo, then you definitely will go home with a prize that night. I will list those prizes next week. Here's the deal. You got to watch the video because the bingo card will be captured in the video. And so you'll have to snapshot it, save it, grab that image. I'm not going to post that image anywhere. I'm going to force you to watch the video, okay? If I'm going to put the time to put that thing together, then I want you to put the time to kind of come look for it. The prizes will be listed there. It's going to be fun. I'm going to have fun with it. There'll be some things like getting on a Zoom call, just a lot of little different things. You have to play a Kahoot. So I'm just going to mix it up a lot. So you have 24 activities to do a full cover bingo. Of course, the middle is going to be our Real Student logo. That'll be your free space. And you can do diagonal across all the typical bingo rules. But have fun with it. I hope you will have fun with it. And I'll have fun with you as well. I won't be able to see you in small groups. I won't be able to see you on Wednesday nights. I won't be able to see you on Sunday morning in small groups until we get back on campus in, like I said, mid-January. But until then, hey, hook up with me. Let's go. Let's meet. Let's see. I may even throw in a go shopping at Walmart at a certain time. I don't know. We're just going to have fun with it. I'm going to fill those squares up. So I hope and pray that you guys will engage us a little bit and have some fun, have some friends come along with you. There'll be some extra squares just to do some things that are with our fellow students, so you won't have to do things on your own. But you guys have fun with this. Have fun getting your collage together, your proof of evidence of your bingo. And then we'll show up on Wednesday night, that first Wednesday night back, in a real student ministry fashion. And we'll have our real worship. We'll have our sermon that night. We'll do small groups. But before all that, we will give away those prizes and you guys will have a good time that night. So, hey, I love you guys. I miss y'all. Have a happy new year. Be safe. And I look forward to seeing you next time we see you. And I pray that you guys are connecting through our Real Student Ministry YouTube channel, Real Students Cabot, and also being here on physically on Sunday morning. We still have worship here and we still have a church service. Love for you guys to come and connect. If you missed out on me preaching last Sunday, I know you guys are missing me. Hey, get back, play that out. I'll probably reel that in one of these Wednesdays coming up too. Hey, love you guys. Talk to you later. Bye.
All right, guys, great to see you again. This is Three Bros You Know, the Christmas version, the Christmas edition.
So, ho, ho, ho.
you see what's happening. So it is what it is at this point. So anyway, we wanted to spend just a couple of minutes with you, just kind of sharing with you really kind of our perspective about the Christmas story, maybe some particular parts of the Christmas story that have really kind of connected with us. And I'm going to start off, but I want to share, it's kind of a part of the Christmas story that a lot of people don't talk about. Not necessarily don't talk about, but they just kind of breeze through it. It's actually out of Luke chapter 1. And we'll start with verse 39. It said, "In those days, Mary arose and quickly went into the hill country to a city of Judah, entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, the baby leaped in her womb." The baby leaped in her womb. And if you're wondering who that baby is, that is John the Baptist. John the Baptist in the womb. "And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She spoke out with a loud voice, 'Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. But why is this granted to me that the mother of my Lord should come to me? Indeed, as soon as the sound of your greeting came to my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. Whoop. Blessed is she who believed, for there will be a completion to those things which were told her by the Lord." So this particular part, I always thought this part of the Christmas story was amazing, because if I'm trying to kind of bring everything back to the reason we celebrate Christmas, mm-hmm. I mean, the quick and easy answer is Jesus, right?
Right.
And from the very beginning, who was John all about? Like pre-birth, like in the womb, he's like excited about being near Jesus. The unborn Jesus, right? And so just that level of excitement and commitment to making Jesus first in your life. And if you skip on over to John chapter 3, John's here and he's got some people coming to him, and it's kind of like, hey, this Jesus guy over here is like, he's baptizing more people than you are. You know, they're trying to get him jealous or whatever. You know, it's kind of ridiculous.
Yeah.
But anyway, John answered, this is chapter 3, verse 27. It says, John answered, it says, "A man can receive nothing unless it has been given to him from heaven. You yourselves bear witness of me that I said, I am not the Christ, but I have been sent before him. He who has the bride is the bridegroom, but the friend of the bridegroom who stands and hears him rejoices greatly at the bridegroom's voice. Therefore, this joy of mine is fulfilled. And right here in verse 30, just like he was as a baby in the womb, mm-hmm. his attitude still remained. He must increase, but I must decrease.
That's right.
John made much of Jesus his entire existence on this planet.
Yeah.
And to look to him as an example of just kind of what kind of attitude I should have or we should have during this season, that part of the Christmas story just really kind of connects connects with me. So that's I know it's not the most common part of the story,
but that's
awesome. That's where it connects with me.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
So tons of joy in that, right?
Yeah, I mean, for sure.
The baby's leaping in the womb, man. So that's awesome. I want to just reiterate that too. I love the Christmas story. I have to wait till after Thanksgiving to get in the Christmas spirit. So if I sounded like the Grinch beforehand,
yeah, I understand.
I'm sorry, but now I'm here. Like I'm ready.
You're
on. Get the Elvis, Santa baby. Yeah, I'm all in, man. Play the songs on the radio. Let's sing Christmas carols at church. Let's party. It's Christmas time, and man, we're just so it's crazy to think that here we are again shooting a video. We're still not going to be able to be on campus and different things like that. But it's Christmas. I think God has some great things in store for us despite that. And in the new year, I got a lot of hope. A lot of prayer has gone in with this group for you guys that we get to come back and we get to more sense of normalcy. So anyway, just real quickly on the Christmas story, I identify with the shepherds. I don't know if y'all know me really well, but I ain't a very smart man. Like Forrest Gump told his love, Jenny, you know, I'm not a very smart man, Jane, but I know what love is. man, I love the shepherds. The shepherds, you know, they were the lowest of the low. If you didn't know that, they were the scum. I mean, they were the people that people avoided. And so when the angel appeared to them, it was like, shepherds of all people? Why? Because God cares for all people. Mm-hmm. And the Christmas story, I think, just reiterates that. Yeah, and, sure. Man, I just love in Luke 2, this is Luke 2, verse 17. After seeing them, this is the shepherds seeing Mary and Joseph and the baby, they reported everything that they saw and heard to everyone that they saw. Right. And we talk about it a lot, right? But if we're to be the messengers of the gospel, if we're to be missionaries where we are, we got to go report the good news with joy
for sure.
And happiness. Joy. So that's what reverberates to me.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I love that. You know, Jason, you talked about the story before the story, right? Talking about John and in the womb, right? Just getting ready for the Christ child to be born. He's recognizing his cuz is going to be here. Then, you know, Mark, you're talking about after, right? You know, kind of after the birth. But when we think about the story, we talk about the Christ story, the typical, let's sit down with the family and let's read the story. It's Luke 2. And I'm just going to read just a brief verse. And it says in verse 9, and while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. Now that's verse 6 and 7 of chapter 2 in Luke. Odd place to find the King of Kings. Odd place to find the Savior of the world.
Craziest.
I'm telling you right now, it's an odd time in the world that we live. And my challenge for you students and parents and whoever's watching this video is that you would look for the Christ child, this season, right? And what he represents. And look for in places that you don't normally look for him. Quit looking for him in the grocery store. Quit looking for him at Walmart. Quit looking for him under the tree. But start looking for him in the least of these. Start looking for him in yourself. Look for him as you look for opportunities to share the good news and be excited like John was. To be excited about the shepherds when they heard. And, you know, the first thing that the angel said, hey, don't be afraid because there's peace coming to you. There's good news. Here's the good news. And the good news is this, guys, that Jesus Christ was born. He was going to die. And he's going to live forevermore because he rose again on the third day and he defeated death. Amen. So that we could have salvation. And we could spend the eternity with God Almighty, the God that loved us enough that he would even send his son, and the son that would love us enough that he would give his life.
Yeah.
So we think about that, and we think about this whole story. Man, get into Luke 1, Luke 2, and just keep on reading until God tells you stop, right?
That's right. Keep going.
And one of the best places you can find Christ more than anywhere else, that you're absolutely going to find him, right? Not in your backyard, not in your refrigerator. but in His Word.
Absolutely. Amen.
And so I just pray that this hits you well, and that you guys take a challenge from us as just old, because we're a little older than you guys. With the fact that we're wearing tinsel and got these hats on, like, and
joint
wanted
tinsel.
To tell y'all Merry joint Christmas. Tinsel. Yeah, yeah, we're joined together. But that at the end of the day, man, there's nothing more important this Christmas season than that first part of that word, and that's Christ.
That's right.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I encourage you to go back. Like, I know we typically go to, like, the New Testament for the Christmas story, but go back to, like, Isaiah.
Oh, man.
And there's many more prophecies throughout the Old Testament, and just that hope and that peace, knowing that God had a plan for us the whole time, to reconcile us to Him. It's just so amazing. I mean, the Christmas story is all throughout the Bible,
right?
Not just in not just there in the Gospels. So yeah.
It's good stuff. Good stuff.
Cool,
man.
Cool.
Awesome. Hey, we're gonna sing "Joy to the World." You sing it with us, okay? Let's sing.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King.
Let every
heart prepare Him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let Him their songs implore.
While fields
and floods, rocks, hills, and plains, repeat the sounding joy. Repeat the sounding joy. Repeat the sounding joy.
Come on, we sing "He Rules."
He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of His righteousness, and wonders of His love, and wonders of His love, and wonders of His love.
Hey, man, that was awesome.
That was good.
We got
that. Joy to the world, brother.
Awesome.
That's cool. All right, guys, let's sing together. Two.
The first Noel, the angels did say, was to certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay, in fields where they keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep.
Sing Noel.
Our heavenly Lord, that blood mankind has bought.
So we're going to sing one more in light of the most important night ever, holy night, when Christ was born. So join in as we sing together.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till He appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices. Oh, in lowly manger, in all our trials He's born to be our friend. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices. Oh, shall cease.
sweet hymns of joy. In joyful chorus raise me, let all within me bless his holy name. Fall on your knees. Oh, hear the angel voices. Oh, night divine. Oh, night when Christ was born.
Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Hey, listen, amen. This Christmas, worship Jesus and look for opportunities to share why you worship. Because many people Absolutely. Are worshiping, many people are celebrating, but they have no idea who Jesus Christ is. So, hey, Merry Christmas. Malik Likimaka.
Oh,
that's a wrap.
Well, what he said. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
From Three Rows, you know.
That's right.